Where's my box? Who steals a box? And how did they steal it with me in it? How am I going to move? This is not a good move. Save money for breakfast.
Yes, I'm the manager.
Don't know what to do right now. Don't know how I got myself here, but I need you, Lord, to bring me out. Cause my life has got a hold of me, and I can feel it pull me down into the ocean of my sin as the waves of doubt come crashing down. Is there anybody who can save me? Or have I sunk it too far down?
What's going on? What? What's going on? She's stealing. What, girl? What? Hey, are you hungry?
Dad, you don't even know me.
It's okay. God loves you.
God does not love me. Because God doesn't exist.
Yes, he does.
God does not love me.
Yes, he does.
Prove it.
I just fed you. Hey, come back tomorrow. I will prove to you that God exists.
How can he prove that God exists? God is not real. I've never heard of it, so I'm sure it isn't real. We have to look out for ourselves. I've always had to watch out for myself. Why would I pray to something that I can't even see?
What brought this on?
I met a guy today. He doesn't know me at all. He doesn't know that my mom abandoned me, and I've been surviving on my own since age 9. And she left when I was 6. I was getting away with it too, till that nurse at school found out. Then I went into foster care. It was okay, but I needed to get out. So, when I was 14, I ran here, and I've been here ever since.
Oh, wow. That's tough.
Oh, you came back.
Wrong. Well,
come on in. You think you will?
I know I will.
Here. What's your name? I'd like to get to know you.
What's it to you? You won't remember it anyway.
Oh, try me. I'm good with names.
What's yours?
I'm Gabriel.
My name's Taviana.
Taviana, that's a cool name.
Thanks.
How old are you?
18.
And how long have you been living on the streets?
4 years. Now how are you going to prove that God exists?
That will come in time. 4 years. You poor dear.
Don't worry about it. I'm doing fine.
Yes. Yes, you are.
Wow. Most people don't think I can survive on my own.
Well, it takes a strong person to make it on the streets, and for 4 years, and you look clean.
I won't do drugs.
See, that's another thing. Kids are usually trafficked or doing drugs after only 2 days on the street.
Well, I know what to watch for.
Taviana, I really want to help you. God is about love. I'd like to show you love, warmth, clothing, food. Actually, I'm going to make some hot chocolate. Would you like some? Here we go. And here. I want you to take this. It's a gift card. Go get some things that you need. I trust you. And come back tomorrow. I've actually got a friend that I'd like to put you in contact with, and I think he can help you.
Why are you helping me?
Listen, I just do what God tells me to do. And right now, he's telling me to help you.
Fine. Thank you.
Oh, wait. I got something else for you. That coat's not going to keep you warm out there. So, I want you to take this. Take it.
Thanks.
Of course.
I don't know why this guy's helping me. Oh yeah, because God loves me. Like God cares about me.
John chapter 3, verse 16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, so that whoever believes in him would not perish, but have everlasting life." I want to tell you about a gift, a free gift that you can have. I mean, who doesn't like gifts, right? You don't have to do anything to earn this gift. It cannot be earned by good works. It cannot be given to you by a family member. It cannot be earned by dipping your toes into a pool of water. It cannot be received by entering a church building. It cannot be given to you by a pastor or even by a really good person. It can only be given to you by Jesus Christ himself. And that's what he did. You see, the penalty for our sin is death. And Jesus was killed on a cross to pay that penalty for us, because he loved us that much. It's amazing, isn't it? The whole Bible is amazing. But since we are God's greatest creation, even greater than the angels, he didn't want death for us. He wanted to save us from that. But he knows not everyone will accept his gift. There are those who will refuse it. Let me ask you a question. What is your life like right now? Are you fulfilled? Or do you always feel like there's something missing? If you have not yet accepted Christ as your Savior, your chains are heavy, weighing you down. You feel so heavy. And day after day, year after year, they just get heavier and heavier, and you feel so burdened. You know, sometimes people think, well, if I become a Christian, then I'm just going to be chained by a certain behavior. And sure, true Christians do act differently than the world does, but they don't feel chained by it. In fact, it's quite the opposite. They feel finally free. But God promises that you get to decide whether or not to accept his gift. But if you do, you will not only receive eternal life, but your whole outlook on life will be different. You will feel different. You'll feel changed. But it's up to you. You can continue to live in your current state of trying to do things on your own, or you can let it go, give it to God, and receive His gift of salvation. So, what are you going to do?
God does not exist. If He did, why would He get killed on the cross for our sins? And how does that even work? Whatever the special is.
Really?
Thank you. I want to talk to you about that Jesus dude.
Okay.
I saw some lady on stage preaching about God, and she said He died on the cross. What did He do to deserve that?
Well, that's a good question. Fact is, he didn't do anything.
Then why did they kill him?
We may never know the answer to that. You see, he was accused of crimes that he didn't commit, and he had to die. But that was a part of God's plan. You see, someone blemish-free had to die so we would be saved from our sins.
Oh, yeah. That's another thing. You can't possibly believe that salvation comes for free.
Yes. Yes, I do.
Oh, come on, Gabriel. Be serious.
I am serious.
Then what about good deeds? Don't they count for anything?
Yes. Yes, they do.
Then see, it's not for free.
No, listen, it is free. No way to earn it. We can do good things, good deeds, to make God smile. But that's it. You can't do good deeds to earn salvation.
And why would I care if I make God smile?
I'm actually not sure how to explain that. You see, there's some aspects of Christianity. You can't truly understand it. You just have to experience it. You know, Teviana, I hate this, but I have to go. We'll catch up tomorrow. Is that okay? Taviana, I want you to know that I think God wants you to see that speaker on stage tonight.
Why?
Because she's my wife.
What?
Yeah. You see, everything that has happened for a reason. God is asking you to be part of His life.
But why does He give salvation for free? That's something He can really cash in on.
But that's not what God wants. If that were the case, then there'd be a lot of people that wouldn't make it into heaven.
Oh, so it's a learning curve.
I suppose it is. It's very difficult to follow God's commandments all the time.
Good evening. Welcome. Thank you for coming out. I want to read from John chapter 8, verse 12. Then Jesus spoke to them again, saying, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. You know, Jesus is the light of the world. The world is dark without his presence. His light shines to illuminate our paths that lead us to him. Ignite our souls, Lord, so that we may lean on your shining light and stay connected to you. Because you are the light that we need so that we do not stumble. As you see each candle being lit, I want you to remind yourself how dark the room was. And as each candle is lit, more and more light will be filling the room. That's the Spirit filling the room with his light and his power. Embrace him. Hold on to him. And don't ever let it go.
Yeah, I mean, it's free, so might as well.
Quite simple, really. Just talk to God. Ask him to forgive you of all your sins. Ask him to come into your home. Do you want to do that?
Yeah, I do. Jesus, I want you to please forgive me and to come into my heart.
Falls apart, he cries out.